going on, guys? How's everybody doing today? I'm doing well. Thank you for asking if I'd be down here. Michael, at your most humble service, today is Friday. It is my new deadlift day. And it's roughly about 4:35 p.m. So, we got the bar loaded up as per usual. 135. This is our warm-up. And like I mentioned, I like to warm up and show it because your warm-ups are just as important as anything else you do today. I'm going to go ahead and break the ice. But first, let me take my shoes off. Anyway, breaking the ice here. I am going to set a new PR today. I've been thinking about it for the last 3 days. And I got my mind set on it. My PR, my deadlift PR, is 455. I've done it one time for one rep, and I did it sometime a little later, a couple months back or so, for one time. So, that's my PR. I'm going to break that today. I'm saying it right here on camera. Let's start with a warm-up, though. It does take me a few sets to get warmed up, get used to moving, bending over, all that stress. If you see me with something on my thumb or whatever like this, I believe it's caused by whatever liver issue I have. You'll get like dry spots on your fingers or whatever, and they'll crack. And my thumb's been doing that now for a couple months or so, longer. It just stays dry right here, and then it stays cracked. And so it's constantly bothering me. I don't know what liver problem I got. My wife could tell you. They don't seem too concerned about it. But you never know. So. Let's do another set. 135. Throw another plate on. Hope everybody's having a good day. Hope you had a good week. This week has been the longest short week I've had in a long time. Of course, we were off Monday for Martin Luther King Jr. Day, but it seemed like the work week was 10 days. So, them kids on that bus drive me nuts. I love them, but they drive me nuts. So, something I've been doing the last handful of times that I've deadlifted is when I get to 225, I don't do a set of 10. I'll do two sets of 5. So that's what we're going to do here. Here we go. So that was my third set, and I'm still getting used to bending over and straightening. So it takes a while sometimes. When I'm deadlifting, I don't like to drink too much water. Of course, you don't want to get too sloshy in the belly. Let's do our another set of 225. Plan of execution today is get in here, get it done. Not a lot of playing around. Get in here, get it done, and get done for the weekend. Let me touch on something real quick before I hit 315. Or maybe after. All right. So 315, I'll probably do a set of 4. Something like that. We're going to do 2 sets. I think. Maybe. Thank you. think that was only four. All right, let me touch on the subject real quick. One of my sisters commented on one of my deadlift videos, and she asked me if I wear a belt or why I don't wear a belt or whatever when I lift. And my reply was pretty simple. You really don't have to wear a belt. A lot of times belts don't even do what you think they're gonna do. For me, what I feel like a belt does is more hold your stomach in and keep you from getting that distended gut, blowing your guts out and kind of giving you that pot belly, which I should have wore one many years ago maybe for that. You're not doing a whole lot of protecting for your back. You would have to be shrink-wrapped in some sort of a casing to keep your entire body from moving, to keep the bones and structure and everything completely still, to keep your back and bones from moving. Your bones are deep inside your body. They're going to move. This is bones moving. So your bones are going to move. It can help with a little stability, but a lot of times, in my personal opinion, a belt is best used when you're trying to keep your gut from pushing out too hard. Like I use it sometimes when I do my hack press. Whenever I'm going heavy on my hack press, because, you know, that's a lot of pressure and weight, your stomach bloats up. So keeping that belt on keeps all the pressure in. So that's my response to the belt. Let's do a set. 315. Those sounded like fake plates. So we got 405 right now. A little bit different format today. I'm just leaving the video going. Get it done. We're just going to bend over, pick it up, and we're going to move on. Bend over, pick it up, move on. Bend over, pick it up, move on. Thank you. Now, I'm going directly up to about 460. Some of you in the comments are going to be like, why didn't you go to maybe 420s or 430s? Or I don't know. It's just what I choose to do. And a 2.5. Let me check the video. It should be 460. We're gonna bend down, we're gonna pick it up. We're gonna strain, we're gonna stress, we're gonna probably fall down. But I gotta pick it up. I gotta do it. I got to do it. I gotta do it. Gotta do it, guys. Gotta do it. Gotta hurry. We gotta get this done. Get in the books. All right, maybe not today. We might not do that today. Feeling pumped all day. Matter of fact, the last couple days I felt secure. I felt positive. That's not that heavy. That isn't that heavy. It's not that heavy. 460 pounds is nothing. It's not. I just don't have it in me. Dang it! I don't have it in me, guys. Let me cut the video and get my thoughts together on what I'm going to do. Stick around. Woo! Well, guys, there you have it. Sometimes things don't go as planned, even though I felt really positive. I felt pretty good. It's just not in the cards for me. Now, I've been saying for a long time that I'm probably about tapped out on my deads. You know, getting even 405 pounds is pretty great for anybody. So I'm still in a small percentage of people there, probably. You know, I've tried to do this, you know, tried to up my game a little bit on my deadlifts, and, you know, things are not working out, so I could be very well tapped out on my deads. I've done really good with my 225, my 315, and the 405 as far as getting some high reps. Really proud of myself for those. And that's what I've always kind of said, that, you know, once you get to a certain point, you know, you can always take these certain weights and do more reps or do more sets or do this or that, still make yourself happy. So, you know, if I don't go up any higher than 455, and if I never pull 455 again, I don't care. The 460, I mean, I feel pretty confident, but again, things, you know, I don't know. It's weird. If you lift weights, you know. You know, if it would have been an hour ago and I came in here, I might have pulled it. If it would have been yesterday, I might have pulled it. If I went tomorrow on my old Saturday deadlift day, I might have pulled it. Who knows? But all I do know is I didn't get it today. I may stop chasing the deadlift, you know, the high rep, the high weight PR. I might stop chasing that because I don't feel like it's going to be worth what I'm going to get. I mean, I've already made myself happy doing what I've done. If you recall, in the very beginning, I had high hopes, a very high goal set at 500. And I'm realistic. I know I'm not going to get there, but I wanted to give myself kind of a big goal to go for. And I'm pretty happy with where I'm at. So, anyway, that's my deadlift day. I didn't really get a lot accomplished. I mean, I at least did do some deadlifts. But, you know, I guess if I'm not going to worry too much about going for the big weight anymore, I don't guess I got to worry too much about it. Just do some of my lighter weight and good reps. So, I don't know. I think this might conclude my going for a record. I think this might do it, guys. And I've said this before, but I think I'm at a point in my life. I think I've been going long enough, and, you know, some lifts you should be progressing a little bit quicker. And I think I should be progressing a smidgen bit quicker on my deads than I am. So I think I'm just at my potential. You know, I'm no spring chicken anymore. And I do have my problems that I have. And I'm so happy and amazed that I've been able to go this long and do this and not hurt myself. And that proves to you right there that lifting, when done correct, does not hurt you. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter how much weight you're doing. It matters how you approach the weight. It matters how you handle the weight. And that goes even for when you see me do like cheek curls or something. I know how to handle my body in such a way that I'm not going to hurt myself because I've been dealing with these ailments and I've worked out for a lot of years in the past and I kind of know how to approach things. So I'm not just some noob that came in here last week and started working out. So those of us that work out, we have some time under our belts. We kind of know how to read things, you know, and you can go out on a limb and do some crazier stuff and not get hurt. And also being 100% natural my whole entire lifting life, my muscles, my tendons and ligaments, everything is pretty much stronger than if I'd been on something. It's a known fact that pharmaceutical muscles don't retain as much strength. The word I'm looking for, you know the word I'm looking for. Like, they break down more. You're easier to get injured more. They just don't have that. And I think a lot of that is because they grew so fast, they didn't give their muscles time to, their muscles and tendons and ligaments and everything, they didn't give everything time to mature, you know, along with it. So I know how to handle heavy weights. Now, I will say that whenever I do barbell curls, even if I do light barbell curls, I'm going to tweak my back. It can anger my back a little bit because my back is just horrible. So sometimes whenever I do like the heavy curls and maybe even go up even heavier and do some crazy cheat curls or something, and with the barbell, not dumbbells, but with the barbell, you know, I can tweak my back a little bit. That's the most dangerous movement for me, are curls. I know it's crazy, but it is. With my bad back, you know, you got that weight out here in the front of you. That's a lot of weight to have out in front of you. 100 pounds is a lot of weight. You go up to 150, 185 or something, that's a lot of dang weight to have out there in front of you, and you're moving it around and your back's having to support all that. So, but I also got to give props to my deadlifts and to my back workouts for helping to strengthen my back enough to handle these kind of things with my squats and deadlifts and my bent rows, and even if I do military presses or something from the floor up over my head, you know, like that, if I have to get the bar from the floor, which I don't do those much anymore. I did in the beginning, but I don't do those much anymore. But I gotta say I've held it together pretty well and really happy. So if this is the final video I do with trying to max out on my deadlift, I'm good, guys. You can't always end on a super high note. But my high note is, I tried, I didn't get hurt, and I've got 455 under my belt. Whether I do it again or not in my lifetime, I don't care. I got it on video, I've done it. That's all that matters. So, and that you continue to work out and continue to take care of yourself. So anyway, this is a super long video and I apologize, but it's kind of a moment that I've been kind of waiting to get to. And I knew at this point, you know, I knew I'd get to a point. So this is that point. And anyway, thanks guys for sticking with me on this journey. And we'll still do deadlifts. We'll do some high rep stuff and we'll do some rack deads and maybe use straps and what have you. I don't know. We'll do some other stuff, guys. But we're done with the max. Okay? Please like, share, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff to The Body Beatdown. That's me, Michael. Let me take a drink of water. Your incredible host of this amazing channel. We're almost at 2 million subscribers, guys. 2 million. Let's try to get to 500, okay? Let's get 500. All right? Like, share, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff to me, The Body Beatdown. And get up, get out, get rad, do it to it. We'll see you next time on The Body Beatdown. Go work out. Leave me alone. I fail! Dang it!
Get up, get out, get rad, and do it, do it!